Lord, I know them and they follow me.
Jesus said to the chief priests and elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' He said in reply, 'I will not.' But afterwards changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Por favor, tenga la voluntad de sentarse. Bienvenido a todos los familiares que han venido, especialmente los esposos de las candidatas o los significant others. Especialmente los hijos que vinieron, que Stephanie, ¿verdad? Cuando entró su hijo, he just went straight for his mom y lo abrazó. Qué lindo, ¿verdad? Es que bello, ¿verdad? Estaba hablando con alguien más, no voy a mencionar su nombre, pero esta es la primera vez que ella deja a su niño con el papá con este fin de semana entero. Y le pregunté con mucha conciencia de que yo sé que es muy difícil para una mujer dejar su casa, dejar su hijo, dejar su esposo. Le pedí, ¿cómo sigues? Ay, papá, estoy contentísimo. Cuando trato de rezar, estoy diciendo a madre, ay, no toques eso. Estás en el cielo santificado. Ay, no, quítate de aquí. Y esa es la realidad de muchas mujeres, ¿verdad? De tener un espacito, de estar a solas con Dios. No estamos solos, pero de estar a solas con Dios, de salir de nuestro contexto cotidiano y de enfocarnos en el Señor Jesucristo. Honestamente, hijas, este es un gran regalazo. Amén. Simply the fact that we can come together and just pray.
I was going to say that we can come together and pray as women.
You know what I mean, right? I do look pregnant sometimes, but that's not right.
No, con mucho cariño he estado aquí este fin de semana escuchando, ¿verdad?, sus confesiones, escuchando sus situaciones también. Y qué bendición, pero honestamente ustedes han estado en el salón, todas las charlas, básicamente, casi todas las charlas fueron dadas por ustedes mujeres, y esto fue organizado por ustedes mujeres. All of this has been organized and done by you women, and it's beautiful. It's not the way we've done things, but that's part of the beauty. That's part of the beauty. So here we have a couple of worlds colliding. If you are in a place where you're like, I don't want to leave, or if you're in the place of, oh my gosh, I need to get back to the house, because, maybe you're thinking, this is happening, I need to get back home, I have to do my homework, I have to cook the meal, I have to do this, family's coming over, and women begin to already think of what's happening, and I ask you to please hold off, just for a little bit more. And I'm not even mentioning the ones who are about to get married. And you're like, oh my gosh, I do this. Hold on a second. There are two worlds that are beginning to combine again. And one is a world that says yes, another is a world that says no, but it thinks it says yes. The gospel today, I'm sure this son that said, yeah, papi, I'll go, I'll do it. He not only didn't go, I bet you he thought he was saying yes. Because he said yes, but he didn't say yes. My sisters, say yes. I just got a throwback to JD B retreat right now.
Said, I will not. So the first son said no.
So we got a problem. Because there is a whole biblical tradition of the blessing coming first to the chosen, and then when the chosen say no, that blessing passes on to the next. All the way back, Adam and Eve, they had Cain and Abel. And we know what happened there. All the way back to Noah, Abraham was Isaac's, Abraham's first son. ¿Cómo se llamaba el primer hijo de Abraham? Ismael. ¿Cómo se complicó la cosa? Imagínate. Sara se enojó con la madre de Ismael, que se llamaba Ada, ¿verdad? Ada. Y wow, se metió este, pensó todo el bochinche allí. Y Sara le dijo a esa mujer, y dice la palabra que Sara la maltrataba. Wow. Ladies, let me tell you what, you guys are beautiful. You guys are beautiful. But when you get ugly, you can get ugly. Am I making this up? No. Because there's nothing more treacherous than beauty used to manipulate. And we read in the Bible now. So the second son, Abraham, también with Jacob. Jacob had 12 sons, and he had like 10 sons with one. Okay, am I getting my numbers wrong?
He had Leah and Leah.
And then with Rebecca, he had two.
Raquel.
Okay, Rebecca's Isaac. Gracias. Rebecca's his mom. Okay. Rebecca. Okay, okay. Rebecca, ella hizo todo, ¿verdad? And Rebecca, she said, Isaac, ven acá, porque tu hermano, digo, Jacob, tu hermano, Esau, you know, he's a hot mess, right? Okay, I stopped trying to get him to shave. You know, like, you come over here. And the blessing that was supposed to be given to the first son was given to the second son. And why is the Lord doing that? Why is the Lord? Because the Lord is preparing the way. El Señor está preparando el camino. Porque Él tenía un plan de salvación. Y nosotros tenemos algunos hermanos en la fe, hermanos mayores, que son nuestros hermanos los judíos, que es el pueblo escogido de Dios. Our Jewish brothers and sisters, they are the chosen people of God because they were chosen to have the seed of this good news, this news of salvation, and Jesus was born a Jew. And Jesus said in the gospel today, I'm giving you this blessing, and you're saying no. So I'm going to give it now to someone who's saying yes. Esta es la alianza que celebramos. This is us saying yes. You are that second son. The church is that second son. Y esta es una tradición, un tema en la Biblia que es muy profundo. Like you go all through the Old Testament and you see that there is the good news passed on to the second son. Always the second son, because God was preparing us. And my sisters in Christ, in this day and age, the Lord is passing the blessing on to the second way of life, because the way we began to say yes to the Lord, we actually kind of said no. But now the Lord is passing this blessing to this new mentality that I invite you to put on right now. But ladies, guess what? It's a battle. If you know it's a battle, let me hear you say amen. Oh, la batalla espiritual no es nada para jugar. Ladies, I invite you to every day, take authority of your family, of your home, of your life.
Porque ustedes son bautizadas, y honestamente, yo estaba hablando con otra candidata en la mañana, no sabemos todo el poder que el Señor nos ha concedido. We don't even realize, you know what, if I was God, I would be so disappointed because he's giving us power from on high to our baptism and we leave it like money left on the table. We don't claim the authority that's given to us. El Señor nos ha concedido poder. Y si tú, como hija, empiezas a tomar autoridad de tu familia diciendo en el nombre de Cristo esa línea del alcoholismo que corre en mis venas, en mí se termina. But you know you have the power to do that. That doesn't mean you're not going to suffer the effect. Yes, smile. And tell them, sister, don't forget your first love. I bet you remember your first love. Or maybe you're like, I'm trying to forget my first love. Yo te conocí desde el vientre de tu madre. Él nos amó primero. We can love because he loved us
first.
He is our first love. Because he loved us before we knew what love is. Such a beautiful line, Justin. Love is not what it's about. We got to be liberated from some of that first stuff. Sus pensamientos apestosos. Oye, yo soy mexicano, ¿eh? Como mucho frijol. Y ya tú sabes, hey, esto es algo serio. This is something serious, right? You know, like, mama cooks a really nice meal, but then 3 hours later, she's like, ¡ay, y eso qué! Something sneaky comes into this room because we don't know how to do that. That stank stays. We keep. Okay. Pensamiento apestoso. No puedo. Right? This self-doubt that permeates, I cannot. Oh, no. If you get a word, like, esto pasa en el grupo de oración, yo siento que el Señor te está pidiendo que hagas algo. Ay, no. Es que no puedo. I did that in my life because somebody came up to me and said, have you ever become a priest? I'm like, yeah. No. Can I just share? Like, I just rejected that because I just wanted to be normal. Like, my family is so jacked up. My family loves me and I love them. But my upbringing has some serious flaws. And I just wanted to, like, say, you know, I just wanna do everything. Y no hay nada malo en eso, ¿verdad? De querer algo que es bueno. Pero lo que el Señor quiere para ti es más bueno todavía. Y cuando el Señor viene con su plan y nos dice, yo quiero que hagas esto, and then you start inventing reasons why you will not be happy, then you are having a pensamiento apestoso. And you're saying, es que no puedo. And what we need to do, our consumer is to pray for priests. For priests, but not. We need to introduce another spray that's for
When we get the pensamiento apestoso, es que no puedo, tenemos que echarle Filipenses 4:3 y todo lo que puedo, Cristo me fortalece. Right? Next one. El éxito. Si no logramos tener ese éxito que pensamos, sentimos que somos un fracaso. Your face, el éxito, the success is that you are here. That you are here and you are saying right now, I am here in Jesus' name. I had a little bit of a revelation when I was in Alabama. There was this priest, a bishop, telling us about our apostolic pardons. Okay, I'm sorry, okay. This is what we priests talk about, okay? Okay, so hay tres condiciones para tener una penitencia, una indulgencia plenaria. Sorry. Indulgencia plenaria, plenary indulgence, which means that all temporal effects of your sin are forgiven. Like when you go to confession, you are forgiven of your sins, but you gotta make up for that. You know what I'm saying? It's like if you lend me your iPhone and I break your iPhone and I give it back to you and say, no, I broke your iPhone, I'm so sorry. Here's like you can forgive me, but I gotta fork out those $800 to make up for that. You know what I'm saying? So there's forgiveness. And then there's remission. You know what I'm saying? The plenary indulgence is the erasing of that remission. It's like you're forgiven and don't worry about those $800. That's what we're talking about. So es una indulgencia plenaria. Y es, hay tres condiciones. De rezar el credo, rezar por el Papa, comulgar, confesarse y... Here's the kicker. No tener un apego a pecados venales, a los pecados. So you can sin and you're like, oh man, I messed up. But that, you know, to be detached from sin, it's like, I gotta do it. You know, I went to confession, but like, I need to eat 7 tacos. He's like, hold on, you know, like there's a bondage there. And he told me, he said, actually, you are detached from those things when you go to confession. So sometimes we think about the exit, but we think about success as this. But honestly, ladies, success is this. Success is this. You think you're a hot mess, you got all this stuff to do. You're here. Look at the person right next to you and say, you are a success. Familia, esperando la perfección. Oh, honestamente, yo soy detallista. A mí me gustan las cosas de una manera, you know, I want it to be beautiful. Okay? Pero cuando esperamos la perfección de nosotros mismos o de otro, lo que estamos haciendo, estamos exigiendo lo que Dios exige. And so we need to bring in the Bible in here to change our mentality. So when you're like you're expecting this perfection, you just need to come in with John chapter 10. Behold, he makes all things new. Or 1 Peter, or also Matthew. Be perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect. Perfection really means holiness. That means given over. Perfection is you being given over. I share this with the crew in Corazón Puro. Having a pure heart is not never having sinned. Having a pure heart is always running back to God. And if you're always running back to Him, that's perfection. Okay? Sí. Tengo varios. Proyectos irrealizables. De vez en cuando tratamos de hacer algo y es un monumento al ego. Y no es tanto un proyecto del Señor. You know how you know if it's really from the Lord? Is that when you go through persecution and it's purified and you're still saying yes. See, this is why sometimes in marriage we need to allow people to go through the fire and do things we're married. You know that there are multiple fires. Thank you.
Pero tenemos que dejar que el Señor purifique a ese sí, a ese matrimonio, y no pensar que nuestro matrimonio es un proyecto. Yo lo voy a cambiar. Es un proyecto que ha realizado porque tú no puedes cambiar a nadie. Ni te puedes cambiar a sí mismo. No. Lo que tenemos que hacer es echarle el frabaibo, frebiblia. Y decir con el Señor, destruye este templo y en tres días lo reedificaré. When Jesus does, he's going to break it down and build it up like nobody can. Destroy this temple and in 3 days I will bring it back. Más que terrible. Falta de paciencia. The lack of patience. Mercy. For this one, I bring to you lo que dice en la segunda lectura. Cristo, siendo Dios, no consideró que debía aferrarse a las prerrogativas de su condición divina, sino que, por el contrario, se anonadó a sí mismo. When you're losing faith,